If you want to program a quantum computer, you don't have to know what the quantum stuff physically are. Just like the ones and zeros inside these computers only matter to us as abstract mathematical concepts. For this reason, I present to you the essence of quantum computing math. Instead of being integers 1 and 0, quantum bits are two-dimensional vectors. For example, this is one of them, which is the qubit equivalent of classical 1, and similarly, there is a qubit equivalent of classical 0. But quantum bits can be more than just 1 or 0. They can also take states in the middle, such as this cat, which can also be converted into a state vector doing some simple math. If we plot it on a coordinate plane, it's just like plotting any other vector. However, quantum states can't be any vector. They're constrained to vectors where the sum of the squares of its amplitudes is 1, which makes only vectors along this unit circle possible. And if we arrange 0 and 1 like this, and also allow vectors to be 3D to account for complex amplitudes, now we get what is known as the Bloch sphere, which encapsulates the complete definition of quantum states, that quantum states are two-dimensional complex unit vectors. Just like my little sister, quantum bits love to play hide-and-seek, so that when you look at this vector, you can't actually see all of its beautiful colors because it will turn into either 0 or 1. How do you know which one it will turn into? The square of the amplitude of 0 is the probability that it will turn into 0. And the fact that the sum of the probabilities must equal 1 is what restrains the length of this vector to 1. Because looking changes the state, some people call measuring a gate. This is a wire. Wires show the change of a quantum bit over time. We can put any gate on the wire. For example, take the X gate, which takes a quantum state and changes it to its opposite. Quantum gates are 2x2 matrices, and for X, its matrix looks like this. You can indeed validate that it does what it claims to do. If you multiply X by the vector, you really do see that the result is flipped amplitudes. Now take a look at this matrix. When multiplied by 0, it becomes a special vector with an equal probability of measuring either 0 or 1. Just like all your computer's power comes from arranging 4 gates together, all quantum computing is done by arranging these quantum gates together. Go to Qiskit, create a quantum circuit with 1 qubit. Measure it, and you can see this qubit is initiated in the 0 state. If we put an X gate, it flips to a 1. And if we put a Hadamard, it measures to 0 and 1 equally. Quantum computing is the future. Now, armed with the math, you can be part of that.